England, who will be defending today against Austin Idol, as we promised you last week, a title match on television.
Seemed like the Tennessee stud was a little bit upset about what went on in that match, and well, of course, maybe he doesn't really he's not very anxious to defend the title, but he has no choice. It will happen.
A gentleman has stopped by our television studio today, and he is not wrestling on television, but he wants to say a few things. We have some videotape. Let's roll it right now and take a look at the action on the last time that Robert Fuller was wrestling in the southeastern area. And this is a match I'm sure that will recall, bring a lot to mind.
Well, that's true, but this has very little to do with why I'm here or the statement that I want to make. I think I've delayed it a little bit because I've had a lot of letters and a lot of people write in asking, where is Robert? And when we see him, we just see him now and again, and he's here and he's gone. I'd like to explain that now. And my plans for the future as far as wrestling goes. First, I want to clear up where my brother's concerned and Jimmy Golden, that we are relatives, but that's as far as it goes. That Ron, I guess he ran into some problems in his life with his knees and with his other ailments and this and that. I ain't going to make excuses for him, really, because he's making a real idiot out of himself. But by that, he's taking on an attitude where he cares for nothing but himself. And Jimmy, it's been obvious that that's his attitude right down the line anyway. If it works out for Jimmy, it's fine. Otherwise, let me get past that. I have something that involves me, and it's important to me to say to my fans that, as people know, wrestling, it's a very tough game, like football or anything else. Intimidation has an awful lot to do with it. That if you go out and you can scare a man, or you get him psyched out before you ever get there, and then go out and meaning at the same time to get done what you said, it becomes a very brutal game. And all of my life, it's like growing up, my father being a wrestler and looking on the possibilities of me doing it, that I became aware very young of people saying, even in school, that your father wrestles, and are you tough? You know, so all my life I've had to put up with that, and I've trained, and I've been bullied in my life. I've never stood up to being bullied without taking a progressive attitude about it. But still, I've gotten to the point now to where, just where I stand, I don't enjoy training like I used to, and I don't have that eye of the tiger, as you say, that attitude about it that I used to have. I'm not standing here proclaiming that I'm retired, but in the same token, to my fans that have written in letters and what have you, that I won't be wrestling as much due to that. I guess you could say it's a semi-retirement. It has some, I guess, to do with the fact of Ron and of Jimmy, that I don't enjoy being around them. I don't enjoy having anything to do with them at all. So please, you know, if you think of Fuller or you think of Golden, don't think of Billy Golden, don't think of Buddy Fuller, and don't think of Robert Fuller. Just let them make a fool out of themselves on their own. I'd appreciate it. Now, thank you for the time, Charlie.
Well, I know it's got to be a very, very serious moment in the life of Robert Fuller. I know he and I have been friends for a while, and I really hate to see him come to that point.
I do too, but I think what he said involving family members, especially remembering Billy Golden, remembering, thinking about Buddy Fuller, that is something to think about. When you think about Fuller, think about Robert. He had to say it, so he did. We'll be back with more of Southeastern Championship Wrestling, the Southeastern title match, Golden against Idol, coming up next.